today's topic is accessing data frame elements through indexing. Now, what is indexing? Already you have done in list also. By default, it starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. And so row label here, you will have the row labels as well as column labels. So by default, it is 0, 1, 2, 3. But we can give our own index. Like while creating data frame, you have learned give your own index. Now in this you can see the row index are math, science, Hindi. So we have given while creating. And the column index are Arnab, Ramit, Samriddhi, Riya and Malika. These are the column index. So data elements in a data frame can be accessed using indexing. So where indexing is used, where you have to access the data elements. Each element or a group of elements you have to access, so we will use this indexing method. There are two ways of indexing data frames: label based indexing and Boolean indexing. Now label based indexing, directly you will give the labels and it will give you the content. Suppose I want to see the math data, so it will give you the math data. If you want to see Arnab's marks, it will show you Arnab's marks. So this is your direct one. And the next one is Boolean indexing, means true and false. Boolean you have already learned, it is output will be true and false. So when you will give a condition that display how, which all students have got more than 95%. Now any condition you have given, so it will give the output in the form of true and false, that yes, this student has got, this student hasn't. So Boolean indexing. Now label based indexing, how it is done? There are several methods in pandas to implement label based indexing. Dataframe.loc is an important method that is used for label based indexing with data frames. Let us continue to use the resldf created earlier. As shown in the following example, a single row label returns the row as a series. Now here you can see this already we have created resldf. So this is already created. Now we will use, first we will use dataframe.loc. You just underline this or you just note it down. So this method we will use first. Yes. Now how to use it? Suppose the marks of science you want to display, and see it is showing in the form of series. How the series are shown? That is the labels, column labels along with their marks. So how to access the science marks of all students? You will write the name of the data frame whichever you have created. In just now you have created resldf in the previous class. So resldf I have used. Dot loc in square bracket science is written. So the marks of science will be displayed. But how it is displayed, the output is in series form. Like this you have to write the output. As in case study, you will get the question and you will be asked to write the output. Now see carefully how the output is written. You have to write in this format only. Till here you can write it. Here, name and D type. If you don't write it, then also you will get marks. So this is over. Also note that when the row label is passed as an integer value, it is interpreted as a label of the index. So when row label will be passed, that time automatically the index, like here you can see, suppose you have given here row label as 2. Now what is this 2? 2 is 0, 1, 2. So that will be accessed. Clear? Integer position along the index. So you can give the integer position also. Now here the data frame is created and you have written the name of the data frame dot loc2. So loc2 will be printed here. So 30 will be printed. But when this is created, by default index again it will come. So here you can see here 0 is written. Of course the value is 30, but always it is printed with the index. So only one value is there, so 0 will be there. If two values will be there, 0 and 1 will be there. Okay? When a single column label is passed, it returns the column as a series. Now here you can see the column will be series. Like here you have previous one, you have seen it is in the form of series. Only one column data is there, so it is in the form of series. Now here colon Arnab, so only all the datas of Arnab you want to display. So here you can see all the datas of Arnab it is displaying. Now see the difference between the two. In the first case, when row was excess, there you have written only science and you haven't written anything else. Only science you have written. This was your row label science. So what it has done, this row labels data along with the column labels, it has converted into series. But when now you are using the column, Arnab you are using, column name, what you have done is, you have given colon before this. That means all the records of Arnab you are going to see. So this is the difference. So here LOC in square bracket colon means all the rows of whom column label you are writing. If you don't want to see all, you want to see only a particular record of Arnab, then that will be mentioned here. So first row label, comma, column label. Clear? If you want to access a single element, like here all the marks of Arnab you have displayed. So the name is Arnab, no need to write the D type. Only this much marks you just show it in copy. Because this exam monthly test also you will get these questions and you have to write these outputs. Yes, so only till here you have to write. Next, also we can obtain the same result, that is the marks of Arnab in all the subjects by using the command df Arnab. This we have already used previously, that is print the name of the data frame and only Arnab, no need to write any LOC. Normally what we are doing, when column we are accessing, we are writing the name of the data frame in square bracket the column name. When rows we are accessing, then data frame name dot LOC then square bracket the row label. So this difference we are doing. For column you will remember data frame name in square bracket column label. So here directly it will show, because this is much more easier than the previous one. But this method also if you use, then also you will get marks. It is not that you will not get marks. So here this method is also correct. But this is a lengthier method. So we are directly writing the name of the data frame and the column label. Only this much we have to write. And with print command, if you write it, then it will display, print the data. So this is done. Now next is more than one data. This in series also you have done. When single data you were accessing, only one name you were writing. When multiple data you were accessing, then with comma, two names you can write. But it will be a list inside this LOC. So here in list, you have written science and Hindi marks you want to see. So how to write it? Data frame name, row, LOC, then in double square bracket you will write the two row labels. So more than one row label if you have to write, then in square bracket you will form a list and then you will write. So this you should remember. If they ask you to write the display the marks of science and Hindi, write the command, this command you will write. If they will give you this and ask you to write the output, then this output you have to write. So in question paper you will get both the ways, either to write the command or write the output. Now next one is boolean. Now some of the students use where function, where clause to display this. So two methods are there for this also. That is, any condition is given to you. Suppose the condition is in maths, those who have got more than 90, you display who has got. So here the output will be true and false. Like here you can see the output, Ramit has got true means more than 90 and Malika true means more than 90. So this is called Boolean indexing. Boolean means a binary variable that can represent either of the two states. true indicated by 1 or false indicated by 0. Now this you have learned last year, always the false or low is represented by 0 and true or high is represented by 1. So here also true means 1 and false means 0. So the output of Boolean index will be, Boolean indexing will be in true or false. In Boolean indexing, we can select the subsets of data based on the actual values in the data frame rather than their column or row labels. Thus, we can use conditions on column names to filter data values. Consider the data frame resultDF. The following statement displays true or false depending on whether the data value satisfies the given condition or not. So here you can see that the data frame name is written with LOC math means the row label is written greater than 90. So all the names, all the column labels will be there along with the output will be either it is true or false. That is, if anybody has got greater than 90, it will show true or otherwise it will show false. To check in which subjects Arnab has scored more than 90, we can write resultset.loc:Arnab>90. This you note down because in board paper this condition, this question is asked. If it is only the row label, then directly you will write the row label. So LOC you will use and row label greater than 90. If it is a column label, then with LOC:Arnab>90. Clear? So let us solve this question. Now suppose the question is a data frame. Let us take a data frame, Airways or any data frame, inventory. So that data frame will be different in your question paper. Like here student data frame is given to you. I am opening a ready-made data frame which is already there. Yes. Now here you can see the data frames are already created. The sales are already created. Now I want to see in which quarter the sales is more than 6,000. So what you will do? Suppose in quarter 2 you want to check. In quarter 2 in which all you are having more than 6,000. So this is already created. I am just pasting it here. Yes. Now the next step will be to display. First one is direct indexing. So in direct indexing, directly you will write here the outputs, like you have seen the output here, that is the row labels are Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4 and the column labels are 2015 to 2018. So if you are asked that display the quarter 2 data, how you will display the quarter 2 data? Anybody? Switch on your mic. Directly quarter 2. So quarter 2 is my row. So directly I am displaying. So this is done. Q2 should be in quotes because it is a string. Numeric, it is a label, so it should be in quotes. Yes. Now you can see the quarter 2 data, that is 2015 this much, 2016 this much. So this is for a row label. So this is accessing. Question will be how to access or display. So access any row label. Now next one is to access any column. A column, yes. Now tell me, suppose I want to access only 2018 or 2017. Now what will be my output command? Name of the data frame dot loc, then colon means
colon.
All, yes, and then 2000
and 2018.
Clear? Now you execute it. It is a numeric value while entering, so I will also enter a numeric value. Yes, now you can see here 2018 quarter 1 it was 5400. From here you can check it, 2018 was 5400, correct? So it is showing the output in the form of series. Now this is over. Now the Boolean indexing. Boolean indexing will be yes. In Boolean indexing, the rows and datas with the condition you have to write here. So what is the condition? Suppose I want to display here print, and then I have to write here in quarter 2 which is greater than 7000. The data which is greater than 7000. So here if nothing is mentioned, then only colon, with that it will work. But if it is mentioned that which row, then I have written here LOC in quarter 2, so Q2, and which is greater than 7000. Now you execute it. Yes, now only one value of quarter 2 you can see it is greater than 7000, that is 2016. So 2016 will be true, rest all will be false. Clear? Now next will be your, this was for row label. Now column label, same method we are using, column label access method only the condition, whichever condition is given, like 2018 which is greater than 6000. So here I have written greater than 6000, and when you will execute it, you will see that quarter 2, quarter 3, and quarter 4 of 2018, you can see these three are greater than 6000 of 2018. 3 will be true and the first one is less than 6000, so it is false. Clear? So this table, if it is given to you and you are given this command and you are asked to write the output, you have to write this output. Clear? And if you are given this output and you are asked to write the query, then you will write the answer this query. Till here, any doubt anybody is having? So this was your Boolean indexing. Now the next topic is slicing. Now slicing of series, slicing of list, string, tuple, already you have done. Same method we will use here. So slicing means more than single element also you can access using slicing, or a subset of that set, clear, of that table, of that data frame. A subset if you are asked to access, that you can access. So accessing data frame elements through slicing is the next topic. This slicing is also asked in exam, so this is also very important. We can use slicing to select a subset of rows and or columns from a data frame. What is slicing also can be asked, so that also you should know. To retrieve a set of rows, slicing can be used with row labels. For example, from data frame name dot loc, from where you are starting till where. Now already slicing you have done using list, in list, in series. We are using colon in between. Till now we were using comma for indexing. But in slicing, you have to use colon. The start value and the stop value is mentioned here. So here you can see the math marks and the science marks are displayed. Next, here the rows with labels math and science are displayed. Note that in data frame, slicing is inclusive of the end value. So this you have to keep in mind. In list, in series, everywhere the stop value was more, one more always. But in data frame, the slicing is inclusive of the end value. In others, list and string and all, it was exclusive. Okay. So this is, you underline this. That is, the last value will be displayed, whereas till now in slicing we were not displaying the last value, we were displaying till the previous one, the end value we were not taking. But in data frame it is inclusive, so this we have to remember. We may use a slice of labels with a column name to access values of those rows in that column only. For example, the following statement displays the rows with label math and science and column with label other. So here, as you are using the row slicing, same comma column slicing also. Only one if you want to see, then only one you will write. From earner to the second one or third column till third column if you want to see, then all three using colon. Colon sign and then the third value you can write. Clear? So here you can see only Arnav's marks are to be displayed. So only math and science marks of Arnav is displayed, because here you have written only math and science. So this is your row as well as column slicing. So this we will practice nicely. Next class I will take a small test also of this, because this is very important. Slicing is asked in every paper. Clear? And little bit practice is needed for slicing. Now the next one you can see, I just want to show the three columns, Arnav's mark, Ramit's mark and Samriddhi's mark in two subjects, math and science. So here the slicing of math and science you have given, and then you can see the column slicing is also given. That is from Arnav to Samriddhi. So from Arnav to Samriddhi, all the records is being displayed. So, we may use a slice of labels with a slice of column names to access values of those rows and columns. So, this, using the data frame, write the statement to access marks of Arnav in maths. Only math marks. So, only math you will write, comma Arnav you will write. So, only math marks of Arnav will be displayed. Create a data frame having 5 rows and write the statement to get the first 4 of it. Anybody who can give the answer of this? To create a data frame, okay, you will use pd.dataframe. How to display the first 4 rows? Which attribute function we will use here? In series we have learnt it.
Head.
Very good. Clear? Like this you have to remember, because in exam you will get these type of questions. So head function we will use to display, head 4 we will use to display the first 4. Here also it will be same. We will write head 4, data frame name, whatever it is given in question. Suppose df is given. So df dot head in bracket 4. First 4 rows will be displayed. Clear? Yes. Now slicing, now you can see in the previous one, from Arnav to Samriddhi, all the columns were displayed. But if you are asking question, the first column and the third column, the second column, you are not asked. Now what we will do, we will use here a list and we will mention the name, column names only which you want to see. So the difference between these two is, colon means slicing, that is the complete slice will be there, whereas comma means only those two columns will be displayed. So only Arnav's data and Samriddhi's data will be displayed. Math to science. Here actually between math and science there are no other rows. So only it is showing two, math and science. But between math and science, suppose in your table, if two more subjects are there, Hindi and IP, then if you write here colon means from math till science, so all the four will be displayed if it is there. In this case, after math, science was there, so only two rows are displayed. Now, filtering rows in data frame. Now, this I have already told you how to filter it with condition. So, in data frames, Boolean values like true and false can be associated with indices. They can also be used to filter the records using the data frame.loc. You just correct it, the spelling will be data frame.loc method. And in order to select or omit particular rows, we can use a Boolean list specifying true for the rows to be shown and false for the ones to be omitted in the output. Okay, so you want to see only those records, so we will mention true for them, and which you want to omit in the output, you will use false. For example, in the following statement, row having index as science is omitted. Now you can see here that true, then false, then true. That means first one is true, so first one is displayed, math marks. In after math, science was there since false is written. This type of question in previous in sample paper, it was not asked. Till now it is not asked in sample paper. Clear? So here you just note it down, because in project you can use it. So first one is true means first row it is showing, second is false, it is not showing science mark, and third one is true, so in it is showing Hindi marks. So with this method also you can do it. It will be easier. Suppose any type of task. Yes
ma'am, series ko omit kar sakte, columns ko omit nahi kar sakte.
इसमें कॉलम्स के लिए तो फॉर्मेट अलग था, पहले कोलन लिख के कॉलम्स को भी ओमिट कर सकते हैं, उसके लिए पहले कोलन लिखना पड़ेगा तुमको, यहाँ पे कोलन करके कॉमा करके उसके बाद कॉलम, कॉलम जब भी लिखते हैं तो पहले रो आता है फिर कॉलम आता है, तो रो अगर सारे दिखाने हैं तो कोलन डाल दो, कॉमा करके फिर ये कॉलम के लिए लिख दो. ठीक है, ये जस्ट इन्होंने, हाँ इन्होंने दिया है, ये एनसीईआरटी बुक ही है, तो एक बार उसको ट्राई करके देख लेना. ठीक है, चलो. जॉइनिंग मर्जिंग एंड कॉन्कैटिनेशन ऑफ डेटा फ्रेम. नाउ दिस टॉपिक